Hey there, YouTube. Wrestling Optimus here. Since the build video for my custom dailies place got so much positive feedback, I figured I'd do a video for my grandstands and commentary booth as well. So, that's what we're doing today. But first, if you're new here, make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel for more pro wrestling and action figure content. Now, let's get to the build. Just like my dailies place, this was made entirely out of cardboard and duct tape. You may have noticed all the Amazon boxes in my last video, but if you don't have any of those lying around, just head to your local grocery store. They're usually willing to part with extra cardboard. I recommend sturdy produce boxes like this apple one. Just avoid any specially coated ones used for transporting wet product because duct tape doesn't stick to the wax. I had to flatten the box in order to get the length that I needed. Full disclosure, I initially measured wrong and only made 3 tiers, but I would later add a 4th. Pictured is the floor piece, the 3 tiers, and the 4 backs for the tiers. Not pictured are the 2 side panels. With the cardboard cut, it was time to start putting the pieces together. Obviously, you can make yours any size, however, I was limited by my air hockey table. Although I could go as high as I wanted, it could only be 4 inches deep. So I figured the easiest approach was to make 4 tiers, each 2 inches tall and 1 inch deep. Then, based on the size of my ring and entrance ramp, I decided it would look best at 2 feet long. Final dimensions, 4x8x24. This is where I realized my mistake and had to make a 4th tier, which threw off my measurements at the top. However, as you'll see in a minute, that actually worked out in my favor. At this point, I only secure the joints to create the basic shape. With the 4th tier added, I finally wrapped the entire thing in duct tape. Honestly, it turned out better than I expected. My old stands were covered in aluminum foil to give it a metallic look. You can also paint it like I did with the stage. But I felt lazy this time and decided to just leave it as dull gray duct tape. Like I said, my measurements were thrown off by my mistake, which created this small overhang at the top. So to make it look purposeful, and to give the whole thing some more structural integrity, I added these 8-inch tall supports. Originally, I was going to do an entire back panel, but this way gives me internal access for future repairs. And here's the final product. I laid down some Lego tape and lined up my Star Wars minifigs. Then, I added background cards from some old figures I had saved up. As for the crowd signs, I just printed out a bunch of logos and designs from Google and taped them to some neon index cards. Then, I used sticky tack, like the kind for hanging posters, to secure them in the minifig's hands. Feel free to leave your sign ideas in the comments. I also decided to build these secondary stands. They're the same dimensions as the grandstands, except half as long due to their placement. So, 12 inches wide instead of 24 inches. Next, I wanted to make a commentary area for my stage just like how it is on Dynamite. So, another project calls for another cardboard box, only this time I'm actually just turning it into a smaller box which will serve as the base. I honestly forget the dimensions, but yeah, it's a box, so 4 sides, a top, and a bottom. Here's all the pieces cut out and ready for some duct tape. Per usual, I started by just doing the joints to give it the basic shape. Especially for more complicated designs, make sure everything is lined up before you start taping, or you'll wind up with ugly looking creases. Then, I covered the whole thing with duct tape. Pretty self-explanatory, just make sure to lay the tape down nice and flat in order to avoid air bubbles and get that nice clean look. As you can see, the box sits on the lip of my air hockey table and needed to be flush with the rest of the stage. One thing to always consider when measuring is the thickness of the cardboard itself. Since the walls were measured to the exact height needed, I had to trim the top and bottom pieces to set inside the box rather than on top. Similar to the Daily's Place logo wall I made for the stage, I decided to add this logo wall to the side of my booth in order to tie it together with everything else. And yes, that's the couch where I film my segments for these videos and the reverse side of my backdrop. As you can see, it too is made of cardboard and duct tape. Speaking of backdrops, the final piece was this AEW and TNT logo wall that ended up looking just like the real one on Dynamite. Again, all I did was Google the logos, copy and paste them next to each other a bunch of times, print it out, and slap it on a piece of cardboard, then cover it with clear packaging tape. I just wish I would have noticed that one big crease in the middle before it was too late. Oh well. And that's my grandstands and announcer's area. Hope you like them. The stands are more or less permanent, but I plan to swap out the ring with my WWE one as needed. After I build a new WWE set, I'll be able to swap out stages too. But for now, I'm just happy doing AEW videos with my custom dailies place. Alright, that'll do it. Thanks so much for watching. Let me know what you thought of these builds in the comments down below. Or, drop an idea for my next build. Thankfully, there's no pay-per-view this weekend, so check back on Thursday for my action figure review of Dynamite. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to do all that normal YouTube stuff. Smash the like button, share with any wrestling or action figure fans you may know, subscribe to the channel, and spread the word. You can also talk to me over on Twitter, at PSUOptimus, or see all my best figure photography over on Instagram at WrestlingOptimus. If you haven't seen my recent unboxing video, you can check that out right here. But until next time, I've been Wrestling Optimus, and I'll catch you later.